It was a rare time for death in Ireland. And in the battle's prologue, many a common man, woman, and child had said goodbye to work, to love, and to play. A child surprised in a doorway. An old man stretched in the street. A young man near a lamppost which he'd clutched when the bullet struck him, and down which he slid when he died. His curious white face, containing wide eyes staring upward, as if asking the sky why this had to happen. A young lassie in holiday attire lying on her face, maybe hurrying home when she heard the uproar, but going too slow. For already on the brilliant white blouse, a purple patch of death was spreading across the middle of the back. All of the goodly company of the dead who died for Ireland. Jesu, have pity. Quiet, comrades. Quiet. It was necessary that you should die for Ireland too. Oh, you didn't want to die. I know. I know. You signed no proclamation. You invaded no building. You pulled no trigger. I know. I know. But Ireland needed you all the same. And many more will die like that before Ireland can go free. You must put up with it. You will be unknown forever. You died without a word of praise. You will be buried without even a shadowy ceremony. No bugle will call your name. No gunshot will let loose brave echoes over your grave. You will not be numbered among the accepted slain. But listen, comrades, listen. Whitman will be there to meet you, and he will marshal you into the march past of the greater dead. And on the cornet, he will play you a final shrill salute. Listen, there it goes.